Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our second lecture on class 11, chapter 5, exercise 5.2. In the first lecture, we already solved the question number 1 to question number 4, and we already taken each and every part of the question number 1 to question number 4. Now, this is our second part of the exercise 5.2. We are going to take questions one by one from question number 5. So I request everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end, because this video is going to be more interesting. I am takes each and every questions from the question number 5 to question number and the last questions of the exercise 5.2. So please make a look here. Our question number 5. What's the question number 5 is simplification. It means we have to solve and find out the simplified answer. This is our statement. It means we have to solve it and get the simplified answer. How we get solved? The power is negative 2, and the power in negative 2 can be changed if we take it into the denominator. So do this. I'm going to take it in the denominator. The power becomes positive 1 minus iota whole square. We have to do same here, 1 upon me 1 plus iota whole square. Now what's the LCM? The LCM of this term is 1 minus iota whole square into 1 plus iota whole square. Now solve this, multiply by 1 plus iota whole square, and here is also 1 is multiplied with 1 minus iota whole square, and we know here a plus b whole square, and here we apply a minus b whole square. So to solve, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Same here, a square plus b square minus 2 into a into b. Now please make a look here. In this, both the terms are multiplied and have the same power. So what you have to do, we have to combine it and take a single power of both the terms. So this becomes 1 minus iota into 1 plus iota, and the whole power becomes 2. Now solve it. This is negative term, this is positive term. It means they are cancelled out. Now 1 square is 1, and we know iota square is negative 1. So I am putting here negative 1. Again 1 square is 1. Iota square is negative 1 divided by 1 minus iota into 1 plus iota whole square. The whole power is 2. Now this is 1 plus 1 2, and 2 is cancelled out with 2. It means we get 0. So 0 divided by 1 minus iota and 1 plus iota whole power 2, which is equal to 0, because if we divide 0 by any number, we get 0. So 0 is our final answer. Now look at the next part, second part of the question number 4th. What we have to do? Simplify. Here we clearly see iota square. So we have to put the values of iota square in this expression. What's the result? 1 plus 2 iota plus 3 into iota square is negative 1. Same we have to do in the denominator. But the denominator terms, firstly I have to check it. In this we have iota square. So we have to do the same steps. Plus 3 into iota square is again negative 1. So we solve it. 1 plus 2 iota, and this becomes negative 3 divided by 1 minus 2 iota, and this becomes negative 3. If we solve this, 2 iota. Now 1 minus 3, we get minus 2. Same here, minus 2 iota, and this is 1 minus 3 minus 2. So we can take negative 2 common. What's the result? Negative. If we take negative 2, it becomes positive 2, and it becomes 1, and this becomes negative. Again I am taking negative 2 common, it becomes 1 plus iota. I am changing the order. If I take negative 2 common, it becomes positive 1, it becomes negative iota. So 1 minus iota. Same here, if I take minus 2, so it becomes 1 plus iota. Now minus 2 is cancelled out with minus 2. What's the result? That we get 1 plus iota. Now the denominator part contains imaginary term, so you have to do rationalization. So I am doing here rationalization, 1 plus iota, 1 plus iota. Now please make a look here, we have to do change the sign, because here the 1 plus iota, so rationalization is 1 minus iota. Now do multiply, 1 into 1 we get 1, 1 into minus iota, minus iota, minus iota into 1, minus iota, minus iota into minus iota, minus plus iota square. And look at the denominator, a plus b, a minus b, so we get a square minus b square. What's the result? 1 minus iota, minus 2 iota, and what's the result? Iota square is negative 1, so we get minus 1 divided by 1, and iota square is negative 1, and here is also negative, negative negative becomes positive 1. So we get a result, 1 minus 1 will be cancelled out, we get minus 2 iota divided by 2, so 2 is cancelled out with 2, we get minus iota. Please make a note. Now we have to do our question number third part. In this, the power is 4h to the power 4n plus 1. So don't worry, we have to take the base and we have to solve this, not to apply any logic on the power term. So apply this. This is basically a term containing complex number in the denominator part. So we have to do rationalization. I am doing rationalization, 1 plus iota and 1 plus iota. And the power remains same, 4n plus 1. Now solve this. First we have to do multiply, 1 into 1, 1 plus 1 into iota, iota, iota into 1, iota, and iota into iota, iota square. Divide by a minus b, a plus b. We get a square minus b square. Now what's the result? 1, the power remains same, 4n plus 1. Now solve this, 1 plus iota, we get 2 iota, and iota square is negative 1, so we get negative 1, 1 square, iota square is negative, 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 positive, the power is 4n plus 1. Now solve this, 1 is cancelled out with minus 1, we get only 2 iota, divide by 2, whole power is 4n plus 1. Now 2 is cancelled out with 2, we get only iota, the whole power 4n plus 1. Now I am doing separate base, that's what we, what can be written, it can be written as iota the whole power 4n into iota the power 1, because if the iota is same, the base is same and power will be add, we get 4n plus 1. But we have to do reciprocal. In this we do separate. Now we can also solve this, iota 4n. 4n means power is multiplied, 4 into n. So we can write power raised to the power power. So it can be written iota 4 to the raised to the power n into iota. And we know what's the value of iota 4 is 1. So we can write as 1 raised to the power n into iota. So final answer is 1, because 1 raised to the power n is also 1. 1 into iota is iota. So your final answer is iota. Please make a note. Now our next fourth part is this. Please make a look here. In this firstly we have to do LCM. So please take it LCM. We get a minus iota b into a plus iota b. Now if we solve this, a plus iota b whole square into a plus iota b, it gets a plus iota b whole cube. So it becomes a plus iota b whole cube minus same here, it becomes a minus iota b और क्यूब, एंड वी नो द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ ए माइनस बी होल क्यूब और ए प्लस बी होल क्यूब. व्हाट द आइडेंटिटी इज ए प्लस बी होल क्यूब इज ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस सी ए बी इंटू ए प्लस बी. और ए माइनस बी इज ए माइनस बी होल क्यूब इज ए क्यूब माइनस बी क्यूब माइनस थ्री ए बी इंटू ए माइनस बी. सो आई एम सॉल्विंग दिस बाई यूजिंग दीज आइडेंटिटीज. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. ए प्लस बी होल क्यूब विच इज इक्वल टू ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस थ्री ए बी थ्री ए बी इंटू ए प्लस बी ए प्लस बी. सेम हेयर द साइन इज नेगेटिव. आई एम सॉल्विंग दिस ए माइनस बी होल क्यूब ए क्यूब माइनस बी क्यूब माइनस थ्री ए बी इंटू ए माइनस बी. Now look at a plus b a minus b a square minus b square. So we solve this a square minus b square outer square b square. If we solve this a cube and we know what's the value of outer cube is minus iota. So I'm writing here it is as minus iota b cube plus. You have to solve this. First thing you have to do multiply with a. What's the result? 3a square b into iota. Now what's the second term is 3ab square into iota iota square. Now do the same step. A cube minus iota cube is minus, it means becomes positive iota b cube. Now do multiply minus 3ab into a minus 3a square b into iota. And negative becomes positive 3ab square iota square. Now same term, it becomes a square and iota square is negative 1. So negative negative becomes positive. We get positive b square. Now solve this. A cube minus iota b cube plus 3a square b into iota. Now again iota square, so it becomes negative 1. So the whole term becomes negative minus 3ab square. Now change the sign. Minus a cube minus b and this becomes positive plus 3a square b into iota. Now this becomes negative minus 3ab square iota square. Again not, please not make around. Again iota square, so iota square is negative 1, so it becomes positive 1. The whole term becomes a square plus b square. Now solve this. This is negative 3 square, this is positive, it means they are cancelled out. Now this is a cube, this is negative a cube, this is also cancelled out. Now what we will got? 3 plus 3, we got 6 a square b into iota, and this minus iota b cube minus minus 2 iota b cube divided by a square plus b square. Now you can take common. What's the common? 2 iota 2 b iota. What's the result? We here get a square minus b square divided by a square plus b square. This is your final answer. Now look at this question. It's very easy. It seems to be very difficult, but it is very easy. You have to take remove the brackets only. If we solve this, what's the result? Root 2 plus iota root 3. This is plus root 2 and this is minus root 3. This is root 3 plus iota root 2 plus root 3 and this is minus square root of 2. Now this term is cancelled out with this term because the sign is changed. Again iota root 3 is cancelled out with minus iota root 3. Now root 2 plus root 2, we get 2 root 2, and root 3 plus root 3 we get 2 root 3. Now 2 is cancelled out with 2, we get root 2 by root 3, and you can simply written as 2 by root 3. This is your final answer. So please make a note. Now I am going to take our next question, question number 6. Show that this is a rational number. This is our first part. And now second part, you have to show it is a real. And we know the condition of the rational number as well as real number. So you have to solve first. What you have to do? You have to take its LCM. What's the LCM of this term? 2 minus 5 iota into 2 plus 5 iota. Now solve this. What you have to do? Multiply 3 plus 2 iota multiply by 2 plus 5 iota plus 3 minus 2 iota multiply by 2 minus 5 iota. Now solve this. First, 3 into 2, 6. 3 into 5, 15 iota. Now do multiply 2 iota with 2, we get 4 iota. 2 into 5, 10 iota square. Now solve here. 3 into 2, 6. 3 into 5, 15 iota. Minus 2 into 2, minus 4 iota. Plus 10 iota square. Here again, a minus b, a plus b. We get a square minus b square. So this becomes 2 square minus 5 iota whole square. Now solve this. Here this is positive 4 iota, this is negative 4 iota. It will be cancelled out. This is 15 positive iota and this is negative 15 iota. This are also cancelled out. Now what we will get? 6 plus 6, which is equal to 12. Now 10 iota square plus 10 iota square, we get 20 iota square. Divide by 2 square is 4, 5 square is 25 iota square. If we solve, then 12 plus 20 iota square is negative 1. Here again 4 iota square is negative, negative becomes positive 25. So we get 12 minus 20 divided by 29, which is equal to minus 8 by 29, and this is your rational number. Because rational number are number, those can be written in form of p by q. It may be positive or negative. So this one is your rational number. Now look at the second part of the question. We have to do same. The numerator is multiplied by the numerator and denominator part is multiplied with denominator part. Now look at this. A plus b, a minus b. The terms are same, only the difference is the sign. So it will, here you are using identity a square minus b square. What's the result? A square is 2 square minus b square is 3 iota square. In the denominator part is also same. A plus b, a minus b. It becomes 3 square minus 4 iota whole square. So if we solve this, square of 2 we get 4. 3 square is 9 iota square divided by 3 square is 9 minus 16 iota square. If we solve them, 4 minus 9 iota square is negative 1. 9 minus 16 iota square is negative 1. So we got 4 plus 9 divided by 9 plus 16. 9 plus 4 13 divided by 25. This is also a real number, because we know rational number is also a part of real number. So we have to prove it is a real number, and this one is your rational number. So please make a note. So now we are going to take our next question, question number 7. In this, we have given Z1 is your first complex number, Z2 is second, and Z3 is your third complex number. And you have to verify that these relations, it means it is nothing, it is basically show your associative property as we already discussed in our first part. And second part, you have to verify this, and this is nothing, basically a distributive property. This is your distributive property of multiplications, and this one is your associative property multiplications. Associative property of the multiplication of the complex number. Complex number. So it's very simple. We have to just put the values and we have to verify left side is equal to right hand side. So please make a look. Here, what is our left hand side is Z1 into Z2 into Z3. It means firstly we have to solve the brackets. Now put the values. Z1 is minus 3 iota. Z2 is what? 3 plus 4 iota. And this one is 2 minus 3 iota. Now we have to solve first bracket. Now do multiplication. 3 into 2, 6. 3 into minus 3, minus 9 iota. 4 into 2 plus 8 iota. And 4 into minus 3, minus 12 iota into iota, iota square. Now further solve, minus 3 iota. 6 minus 9 plus 8, we get minus iota, minus 12, iota square is negative 1. So this becomes minus 3 iota, 6 minus iota, negative becomes positive. So we get a result minus 3 iota, 12 plus 6, 18 minus iota, which is equal to 18 into 3 minus 54 iota, negative positive 3 iota. Square. So this becomes minus 54 and iota square is negative 1. So final answer is what? Minus 54 minus 3. 54 is iota. Minus 54 iota minus 3. This is your left hand side. Now you have to solve the right hand side. What's the right hand side is? Z1 into Z2 Z3. Put the value. Z1 is minus 3 iota. Z2 is 3 plus 4 iota. And we have to do first multiplication. Then we have to multiply with Z3. 2 minus 3 iota. Now solve this. Minus 3 iota into 3. Minus 9 iota. Minus 3 into 4 minus 12 iota square. 2 minus 3 iota minus 9 iota and this becomes negative 1, so we get 2 minus 3 iota. Solve this. Minus 9 iota, negative becomes positive, it becomes positive 12. This is 2 minus 3 iota. Now to multiply, minus 9 into 2, minus 18 iota, minus 9 into 3 plus 27 iota square. 12 into 2 plus 24 and 12 into 3 minus 36 iota. Now solve this. This is minus 18 minus 36, we got minus 54 iota. This is plus 27, iota square is negative 1, plus 24. We got minus 54 iota, minus 27 plus 24, which is equal to minus 54 iota. And minus 3 iota. This is equal to left hand side. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So it's very very simple. You have to do it yourself. So do it yourself because all the steps are same. You have to just simplify the equations. Please make a note. Now this is one of your question number 8. What you have to do? This, if this is equal to this, it means this is a complex number and this is a complex number, and you have to calculate the values of A and B. And again repeat the concept, you find in any equations a symbol equal to, then you have to do only equating. Real part is equating with real parts and imaginary part is equating with imaginary part. First you have to make left hand side the whole term as a single real part and imaginary part. And that you have to do same at the right hand side to make all the combined terms to make a single real term and make a single imaginary term. Now please look at here. In this 3, is your real number and a is also a real number, so we have to make it a single real number. So we have to solve this. 3 plus a plus iota b is equal to 5 plus 8 iota. Now look at the right hand side. 5 is your real number, so it's a single, and 8 is your imaginary number. So this one is a correct form, but this is not a correct form. You have to write in terms of 3 plus a, this is your real number, and iota b is your imaginary number, because we know if any number is connected with iota, it becomes imaginary, and other number is real number. So equating, we have to do equating real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. So here, what's the real part is 3 plus a, and here the real part is 5. What's the imaginary part is p. Please keep it in mind. Iota indicates that part is your imaginary part, but not you have to write the iota. So in this, b is your imaginary part because it is connected with iota. Same here you have to do. What's the imaginary term is here? 8, not 8 iota, it is only 8. So the values of b is 8. And if you calculate here, a is 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. This one here, a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 8. Same we have to do in our next part. In this, we have to calculate the values of x and y. And in this, the right hand side is the correct form, because 4 is your real part and 1 is your imaginary part. But in this, here real plus imaginary, in this again real plus imaginary. So we have to first solve it and make it a single real and single imaginary. So to multiply, x into 2 we got 2x, x into minus 3 minus 3x iota, iota y into 2 2y iota, iota y into 3 minus 3y iota square, which is equal to 4 plus iota. Now further solve. 2x minus 3x iota plus 2y iota, and here iota square, and iota square is negative 1, and this one is also negative, so it becomes positive. We get plus 3y square is equal to 4 plus iota. Now what's the real part is here? This one and this one. So we combine it, it makes that 2x plus 3y square is your real part. And if we take iota common, I am writing first positive term, so in this we get 2y, and in this we get minus 3x, which is equal to 4 plus iota. Now you have to do equating real part is equating with real part, and imaginary part is equating with imaginary part. What's the real part is here? 2x plus 3y square, which is equal to 4. And what's the imaginary part is here? This 2y minus 3x is equal to 1. Wait a minute. Here this is not iota square, this is only I. Because I am right, the values of iota square is negative 1. So y remains same. So it will remain same y. Please make up no corrections. Now we have to solve these two equations. We have to use either substitution method, elimination method, or cross multiplication method, and I have to calculate the values of x and y. So do it yourself. Now if you solve this, firstly I will take this side into the right hand side, and using elimination method we have to do balance the coefficients of term. So I am doing balancing the coefficients of x, that's why I am multiplying it with 3 and multiply by 2. So we get 6x and minus 6x. So we get these two equations. This is positive, this is negative, cancel out. And we got 9 plus 4, 13y is equal to 14. We get y is equal to 14 upon me 3. Now put this value into this equation and get the values of x. X is equal to 5 by 13. You have to do it yourself. Please make a note. Our next question is question number 8, the part is 3. If this number is equal to a plus iota b, and you have to prove this. So prove have to, how to prove that? You have to take left hand side and make it equal to the right hand side. So firstly we have to calculate the values of A and B. Then how we calculate the values of A and B? Please make a note here. What's the given? Here, what's the given? We have x plus iota y whole square is equal to a plus iota b. Now we have to, firstly we have to solve the a plus b whole square. What's the equations? A square plus b square plus 2ab. Now a plus b iota beta as it is. Iota square is negative 1, so put the that values x square minus y square plus me 2xy iota is equal to a plus iota b. Again we get here the sign equal, so we have to do equating. Equating real parts to real parts. Now we have to solve equating real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. Now we have to do same. First is x square minus y square, because in this iota is not present, so this becomes a real part, and in this real part is a. And what is imaginary part is here 2xy, because it is connected with iota. And what's here the imaginary part is b. It means we get the values of a and b. Now we have to put it on our left hand side. What is our left hand side is a square plus b square. A square plus b square. Now put all these values. A square value a is this x square minus y square whole square minus y is, what's the values of b is 2xy whole square. Now please solve this applying a minus b whole square. We got a square plus b square minus 2ab. Same here, 2 square is 4, x square, y square. Now we can write as x4 plus y4. This is minus 2 and this is plus 4. So we get plus 2x square, y square. Plus 2x square, y square. Now this becomes, it can be written as x square square plus y square square plus me 2 x square y square. So this is nothing, it is basically x square plus y square whole square. So we got x square plus y square whole square, and this is our right hand side. It's very easy to solve, because such type of question, if you found, prove that you have to do. First, find out the values of the undefined variable like a, b, x and y. Then you have to put all these values in the left hand side and to solve and get the values of right hand side. This is the method to prove the questions. Now look at the question number 9. Determine real number x and y. It means we have to calculate x and y. And this is, it means this question is similar as we already did. I am going to take another example, but the remaining question you have to do it yourself. So in this again we get equality, so we have to do separate. In this no iota is connected, it means this is real part and the whole part is connected with iota, it means this one is imaginary. Again this one is real, this one is imaginary, so we directly equate real parts to real parts and imaginary parts with imaginary parts. But we will go 2x is equal to 4. And here 3x plus y is equal to 10. Now solve this. X is equal to 2. If you put this values, 3 into 2 plus y is equal to 10. 6 plus y is equal to 10. It means y is equal to 10 minus 6. This is very simple. Now you have to do it yourself. Again I am doing. Now the remaining question you have to do it yourself. Now multiply it. 3 into x we got 3x. 3 into iota y means 3y iota minus 4x iota minus 4y iota square, which is equal to 1. And you can write 1 as a complex number, because 1 is also a complex number. How you can write it? 1 plus 0 iota. It means, because real part is 1 but the imaginary part is not given, it means imaginary part is you have to take 0. So this one is, can be written as 1 plus 0 iota. Now solve this. 3x plus 3y iota minus 4x iota, and iota scale is negative 1 and here is also negative. This becomes positive 4y, which is equal to 1 plus 0 iota. Now what's the real part is here? 3x plus 4y. This one is here real part. If I take iota commons, what I will get? 3y minus me 4 into x, which is equal to 1 plus 0 iota. Now equating 3x plus 4y is equal to 1, and this one is 3y minus 4x is equal to 0. If we solve this, we get 3y is equal to 4x, or what's the value of x is 3y divided by 4. Now we have to put it in this equation and get the values of x and y. So do it yourself. Now if you put these values into the equation, this you will got this value. If you solve this, you get y is equal to 4 by 25 and x is equal to 3 by 25. Please make a note. Now I am going to take next question, question number 6. Same part, but it is something lengthy, so I am doing this question also. What you have to do? Firstly, you have to take its LCM. 3 plus iota into 3 minus iota. Now you have to do its multiplications. So what we will put? 1 plus iota into 3 plus iota into x minus, now you have to do multiply it with 2. 2 into 3 minus iota into iota. Same here, we have to do multiply it with what we will get. We get 2 minus 3 iota into 3 plus iota, 3 plus iota into y plus, if we multiply it with iota, we get iota into 3 plus iota. And here iota, and we can write in terms of it a complex number, because in this real part is not given, so we have to take it 0. So it can be written as 0 plus 1 into iota. This is your complex number. Now solve this. We have multiplied 3 into 1, 3 plus 3 into iota, 3 iota plus iota into 1 iota plus iota square, and 2 multiply with x. Now same here, firstly multiply with 2. 2 into 3, 6. 2 into minus iota, minus 2 iota, into iota term as it is, plus 2 into 3, 6, 2 into iota, 2 iota, minus 3 iota into 3, minus 9 iota, minus 3 iota square, and y term as it is. Same here, iota into 3, 3 iota, iota into iota, iota square. Here, a plus b, a minus b, it means we get 3 square minus iota square. Now solve this further. 3 plus 3 iota plus iota becomes 4 iota, and iota square becomes negative 1 into x minus, now multiply iota with 6, 6 iota minus 2 iota square. Now 6, 2 iota minus 9 iota minus 7 iota minus 3 iota square is again negative 1 into y term as it is, plus 3 iota, and again iota square is negative 1. 3 square is 9 and iota square is negative 1, so it becomes positive 1. Now solve this. 3 minus 1 2 plus 4 iota into x minus 6 iota, iota square is negative 1 plus 6 माइनस 7 आयोटा माइनस माइनस प्लस प्लस 3 इंटू y प्लस 3 आयोटा माइनस 1 डिवाइड बाई 9 प्लस 1 विच इज इक्वल टू 10. नाउ सॉल्व फर्दर मल्टीप्लाई x वी गेट 2x प्लस में 4x आयोटा. नाउ सॉल्व माइनस 6 आयोटा एंड नेगेटिव बिकम्स पॉजिटिव 2 प्लस 6 प्लस 3 9 माइनस 7 आयोटा इंटू y प्लस 3 आयोटा माइनस 1 डिवाइड बाई 10. नाउ डू फर्दर सॉल्व 2x प्लस में 4x इंटू आयोटा. नाउ सॉल्व दिस नेगेटिव सो ऑल द टर्म्स बिकम्स चेंज. दिस 6 आयोटा बिकम्स नेगेटिव 6 आयोटा एंड बिकम्स माइनस 2. नाउ डू मल्टीप्लाई y इंटू 9 वी गॉट 9y माइनस 7y आयोटा प्लस 3 आयोटा माइनस 1 डिवाइड बाई 10. Now we have to do separate real part as well as imaginary part. What's the real part is here? 2x minus 2 plus 9y minus 1. This is our real part and to separate imaginary part, iota. If I'm going to take iota as a common, but we will get 4x minus 6 minus 7y plus 3 which is equal to 0 plus iota. Now we can equate to solve 2x plus 9y and here minus 2 and minus 1 we get minus 3. And what's the real part is here? 0. It means we get 0. This is our first equation. Now solve second imaginary part. 4x minus 7y minus 6 plus 3 we get minus 3. Imaginary part is 1. So we get 1. So this becomes 4x minus 7y. If I take minus 3 minus 1 we get 0. So 4x minus 7y minus 4 is equal to 0. This one is your second equation. Please make a note. Please do a corrections here. What we did wrong here, in this we take LCM 3 plus iota and 3 minus iota. And we solve this, we have to multiply 1 plus iota x into 3 minus iota. But I multiply it with 3 plus iota. So I am changing here the sign is negative and I do correction. So please make a not after the correction. So I did a corrections by changing the 3 minus iota. We get this result. Now we have to do further solve. I am solving here. This is our real part. And again we forget to divide by 10 also. Divide by 10. Now solve. We have to do separate real part. What's the real part is here? 4x plus 9y. And this is minus 2 minus 1 becomes minus 3 divided by 10. This is your real part. And in this iota 2x minus 7y minus 6 minus 3 divided by 10 which is equal to 0 plus iota. Now equating real part 4x plus 9y minus 3 divided by 10 is equal to 0. So 10 into 0 we get 0. So 4x plus 9y minus 3 is equal to 0. This one is our first equation. Same we have to do here. 2x minus 7y minus 3 divided by 10. What's the imaginary part is here? 1. So we have to do 2x minus 7y minus 3 is equal to 10. 2x minus 7y minus 13 is equal to 0. Now you have to solve it and get the values of x and y. Please do it yourself. So we here get two values and I am solve these two values. First equation is this is your first equation 4x plus 9y minus 3 is equal to 0 and second equation is 2x minus 7y minus 13 is equal to 0. Firstly we have to balance the coefficients, so that's why I am multiplying this equation by 2. 2 into 2 4x, 2 into 7 14y, 2 into 13 26. Now change the sign, 4x cancels out with 4x. 14 plus 9 which is equal to 23, 26 minus 3, 23, we get y is equal to minus 1. If we put this value in the equation, we get x is equal to 3. So y is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to 3 is your final answer. Please make a note. So we completed our question number 5 to question number 10 with each part. Then we will proceed to our next question, which is your additive inverse, multiplicative inverse, conjugative. All these concepts we will discuss it within our next video. So I am really thanks to watching my video from start to end. If you really like my channel, so please do subscribe and please make a press on the like button and share it with your friends. So we will meet as soon as possible to take a new video. Thank you once again.